be nice for what to me? Georgia.
Hey guys, welcome back. So I'm on a road trip right now and I just checked into my hotel, but the room isn't ready yet and they're gonna give me a call when it is. So today, as you can tell, it is pretty wet and rainy. It didn't start out like that. It was so sunny as you saw in the previous clips, just glorious. And I thought that I would explore Savannah because I'm in Savannah, Georgia right now. I thought I would explore Savannah in some sunshine, but that didn't happen because of course we're still in the wet and rainy season. But while we're waiting for the hotel to be ready, for the room to be ready, we're gonna go and explore some bookstores and maybe find a nice little cafe to chill at. Okay, so I found a few bookstores that are in walking distance. Again, it is raining. I don't have an umbrella, so we're gonna be a little adventurous and we're gonna do the BookTube Coz factor with the rain. But the first one that we're gonna go to in Savannah, Georgia is called Books on Bay, and hopefully they have some really interesting finds and we'll see exactly what's in store. So let's go. So guys, I'm in this antique store and they really have a lot of furniture, but not too many books. But I was able to snag two leather-bound books, and the woman who works here is trying to find out exactly how much they cost. The stories sounded really interesting. One of them was like a murder beach-themed kind of thriller, and the other one just seems like it's about a man's summer days, maybe, so I'd have to take a look into it. But I'm gonna get the prices and see if I'll take those out of this antique store, and then we'll go ahead and check out another bookstore. I'm in my second bookstore, Books on the Bay. A lot of the books are very antique, and there are a lot of children's books in here. The best find that I found was a Johnny Mercer-esque type of book, Midnight in the Garden of Good and Evil, so that would be perfect for Savannah, of course. Okay, so I'm in a section of the bookstore where it actually has something that says authors you should recognize, and it's actually perfect because I'm finally recognizing some of these authors like Kipling and Pat Conroy, and of course Jane Austen, so I'm gonna go ahead and look through these right now. The third and final bookstore for today. It is very difficult navigating Savannah. The streets are crisscross, applesauce, I don't know. But yeah, I see somebody on their break. I think they might work in one of those hotels nearby. And I'm gonna ask where that bookstore is. It's supposed to be the Book Lady Bookstore in Savannah. I just happen upon this really pretty square with a fountain in the back. See that? I always want to call these weeping willows, these kind of trees that you find like in the bayou in the south, but especially known for Savannah, Georgia, I think. But I think it's the south, really. I think they call them Spanish moss, so there you go. But yeah, I'm gonna go ask somebody for help because I'm about this tired of walking about aimlessly, wandering, trying to find this bookstore. I just want to find one more bookstore so that way we have a solid three at least for the video. And then later on, maybe we can go to a cafe and enjoy a cup of tea or like maybe a pastry or something like that. Still walking around very aimlessly. The best part about it, we have a lot of beauty to look at. The trees are just amazing here. I look like the guy from Sin City, Elijah Wood's character, Kevin, because of my glasses. Oh my gosh, and you know my mascara is running probably. Let me quickly wipe this off. So I just had a very, very long walk from the Book Lady bookstore to the parking lot that we parked our car for the day. Yeah, and it's been pouring rain, so I'm completely drenched. I look like I took a shower or washed this hair here. But yeah, so right now we're gonna go back to the hotel. I am going to do an impromptu book haul just to show you what I got. This sucks, guys. Some of my books got wet, of course, you know, especially dealing with like a paper bag. Look at this. So you can imagine some of them got a little wet, but it's okay. I'm not fretting too much. I'm going to let them dry and enjoy them. And it'll just be a memory if I ever see a watermark or water stain on the books. But I'll catch you guys back at the hotel when I'm kind of dried up and I've changed clothes and etc. So here's an overview of the river from this position. It's really beautiful. But again, it's pretty rainy out there. And there's also backlit here, guys. It's pretty cool for the TV area. So little button here. This one right here. Okay guys, so I'm going to get all cleaned up, do my skincare, order some food, and of course show you what books we got today. I'm so excited to share them with you. They got wet, as I said before, but yes, I feel like I've already taken a shower with how much of soaking I've gotten today, but yeah, just give me one moment and I'll be right back with a book haul. Had to plop myself right here in front of these windows. You have the beautiful Savannah River behind me. I absolutely love it. I think it's so peaceful. So we're gonna do a super quick book haul. I just wanted to share with you all of the different books that I picked up today around town. It was such a fun day. I got rained on, I walked a lot, and I smelled a lot of delicious food that I wasn't able to really stop by and eat because I don't know. You know when you have parking, time is metered. Time is of the essence. That's what was happening to me. So, you know, gotta move about. The main thing that I really wanted to do was go to different bookstores, and I even went into an antique store, and I did so. I think Lone Fox would be very, very happy, as well as Exo McKenna, if you guys ever watched them. But anyway, let's stop the rambling and get into the book haul, the book tour, I was gonna say. Oh my God. So the first book that I picked up was Agatha Christie's Murder on the Orient Express, The Queen of Crime, is that what they say? The detective mystery queen. This story kind of focuses on this group of varied characters on this. Oh my God, that's so pretty. Look at that. That looks like a steamboat. Savannah Bell's Ferry. That's that one over there. And then this beautiful other one over here. Oh, it's so nice. I should just be like this. Watching it go by. It's so pretty. It's like, is somebody getting married?
You guys, this city really feels like New Orleans. For sure. Okay, back to the book haul. So, Murder on the Orient Express, these characters are on this express train, this locomotive in Europe, I believe, and somebody ends up dead in their boxcar. And of course, there's a detective on board who's trying to figure out who done it. There's so many different characters. We have like a princess, we have a hoity-toity type of group, mother-daughter, the rude cigar-smoking man, the shifty-eyed skinny person. You have commoners, but you have folks in higher income brackets and folks who are a little bit lower income. And yeah, you have students, you have professors, you maybe have doctors as well as retired folks, but a lot of different characters. And I still don't know who exactly did it because I'm filming that video. But yes, Murder on the Orient Express, I cannot wait to finish reading this. I am listening to it along with the one, the only, the great Dan Stevens. He does amazing audiobooks, you guys. I'm currently actually listening to one and reading it. I think it's called The Timekeeper by Mitch Albom, one of my favorites. But yes, Dan Stevens is really, really good. So that's that one. Now, I recently did another book haul and I had J.D. Salinger's biography by Salerno, is it? I forget. But yes, I saw The Catcher in the Rye at the Book Lady. I don't know, you guys. I'm so sorry I'm not going to remember these these bookstores that I went to today. I found this at one of my bookstores, of course, today, and I just had to pick this up. Again, I hear this is a very famous work from Jerome Davis Salinger and that it deals with a lot of different emotions. If you want to know a few details about that, I would definitely check out my other book haul and I will link it. I think it's gonna be up here. Now, Ready Player One by Ernest Cline. I've seen the movie Ready Player One by Steven Spielberg, I think, and I really love this kind of fantasy world, the sci-fi video game realm that was created in this world. Basically, we have, we have various characters, Parsival and Artemis, and they're in this kind of digital oasis where they're earning points for money, and there's an end goal, of course. So let me just read some of the back for you. It says, in the year 2044, reality is an ugly place. The only time teenage Wade Watt really feels alive is when he's jacked into the virtual utopia known as the Oasis. Wade's devoted his life to studying the puzzles hidden within this world's digital confines. Puzzles that are based on the creator's obsession with the pop culture of decades past and that promise massive power and fortune to whoever can unlock them. But when Wade stumbles upon the first clue, he finds himself beset by players willing to kill to take this ultimate prize. The race is on. And if Wade's going to survive, he'll have to win and confront the real world. He's always been so desperate to escape. Again, so escapism. So I'm very excited for this. The movie was really, really lovely and I got to see that in theaters a few years ago. This very nice copy of this random book. I've never heard of this author nor this title. It's called How I Spent My Summer Vacation. It gives me very thriller vibes. And according to what I saw online about this particular book, this person invites her friend to a vacation home and somebody ends up dead in their bed. So that's about as much as I know about this particular story. So I can see this as being very I Know What You Did Last Summer vibes. It's like beach vibes, but with a very psycho killer kind of aspect to it. Now, I did go shopping with my sister. So she picked up this book called The Great John L. Okay, so she basically wanted to pick this up because this story actually inspired a play. And there's a lot of like visuals in here and illustrations and pictures of what's going on in the actual play. So very old Hollywood. Think of Bing Crosby and that kind of era. So we're really into this kind of thing. So that's why she picked it up. So it's called The Great John L. So that was her pick. Oh, another pick of hers is The Kalahari Typing School for Men. So I think this is kind of a detective-esque novel as well. This one is my sister's pick. So this author, Alexander McCall Smith, they had a book that was called The Number One Ladies Detective Agency. So it's become an international sensation. It's kind of like a continuation or a spin-off of a previous story. So if anything, we can quickly read a little bit of what it says here. Okay, so this person who runs this agency, okay, they're the founder. Their name is Precious Ramotswe. She's looking at her life with pride because she's reached her late 30s and she has a house and she's adopted two children. She has a good fiance and many satisfied customers. But life is never without its problems. Her adopted son has a somewhat troubling hobby. Her assistant wants a husband but can't find one. Meanwhile, the satisfaction guaranteed detective agency has opened up across town and seems to be getting all the attention. Okay, that's the name of the actual detective agency. So yeah, hers is number one ladies detective agency and the competitor is satisfaction guaranteed detective agency. Oh my goodness. So yeah, I guess they're going to be at war with one another. So that could be a very riveting story. So that would be that one. And it's again called The Kalahari Typing School for Men. So I love stories like this too. The very next book is called His Excellency, which is George Washington. He's the first president of the United States. He's on the dollar bill, if you didn't know. This book was written by Joseph J. Ellis. And Ellis is a Pulitzer Prize winning author of Founding Brothers and American Sphinx, which I have never read. Why I wanted to pick this particular book up was because there's like a tiny little note in there. I don't know if you guys can see that, but it says good read. I was like, oh my gosh, this is so nice. It just made me want to read it immediately. And it's always good to know, you know, more and more history. So I just picked up His Excellency, George Washington, of course. It's controversial. We already know this, you know. Anything prior to 1964, the Civil Rights Act, is going to be controversial. Whoever is leading the country. Truly. Next, I pointed out this autobiography by Christopher Eccleston and it's called I Love the Bones of Youth. And my sister is pretty fond of his work. I think he was one of the first doctors in the newer Doctor Who, number 9, I think. Yes, and we really enjoy autobiographies in the house. And I, you know, one day when she's done reading it, I'm definitely gonna go ahead and read it too. So it's just gonna be about his life. We do like that here. So the next book that I picked up around town today was called A Very French Christmas, The Greatest French Holiday Stories of All Time. I thought this was so pretty, especially the cover. It's super, super cute. What really got me interested was the very first sentence. It's about somebody who apparently loathes and hates Christmas. And there's a lot of like different stories, as you can see. There's one called The Gift, Saint Anthony and His Pig, and it's by different French authors, I think. The Louis d'Or, Christmas in Algiers, The Wooden Shoes of Little Wolf, Christmas Eve, and it goes on and on and on. There are more here too. Okay, so there might be little short stories by French authors. So just to read the very first sentence from The Gift, which is why I picked up this book, it says, "To be honest, I've always loathed Christmas. Of course, it was a bit different when the children were little and ran around the house clapping their hands, but that didn't last too long." I was like, oh, I'm sold. I really want to know what the heck is going on in this. So I picked this one up and I'm so happy I did because I think I would have been thinking about it if I had left it in the bookstore. And my final book that I picked up today, I couldn't be happier. I couldn't be more thrilled. I got Orhan Pamuk's A Strangeness in My Mind. So Pamuk is a Turkish Nobel Prize winner in literature. I always want to say Nobel Peace. It's not all Nobel Peace. It's like math, engineer, chemistry, science, all of that. There's so many different categories. I always say Nobel Peace. But yes, he won the Nobel Prize in literature. I'm not quite sure if it's for this book. I should know that. But I did a paper on him in undergrad and he's always kind of left a mark on me. I really liked his essays that I did read and I picked up a few books from him such as Snow. And I think he has like The Innocence of Objects, which is really cool because I love the way that everything is pictured. These like antiques and cloths and fabrics and all of these kind of tchotchkes and special little memories of Orhan's life have been photographed and been collected into this nice, really beautiful, rich book. It's like, it's gorgeous. I really like that style, if you couldn't tell. But yes, I think this story deals with this woman in Istanbul, Constantinople. And I think it has to deal with Orhan writing these love letters to this woman in Istanbul who works as in a bazoa. Something like that. And that's the extent I know of this story. It's of course translated. I'm going to read it and tell you guys my thoughts, but I had to pick up Pamuk's work. I kind of want to read all of his collections one day. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. It was very fun to film and I had a ton of exciting twists and turns throughout the day, especially with the weather. I hope that the different books that I picked up gives you some ideas as far as, you know, different authors and different genres to pick up, because that's exactly what book hauls are meant to do. They give you a few more options. So I'm very happy that I was able to do this video today in Savannah to see what exactly people are reading. And it's pretty much the same down in Florida or New York. I just want to thank you guys so much for joining me today and I hope to see you in the next one. Have a good one. Bye.